Amen. Welcome to tonight's Easter Cantata. Give our musicians, our choir, a big hand as we welcome you tonight in Calvary. You may be seated.
The streets of Jerusalem were teeming with excitement. It was the Passover festival. People had traveled for miles to join the festivities. But this Passover was unlike any other, for Jesus, the long-awaited Messiah, was making his way into town, riding on a donkey, just as the prophet Zechariah had foretold.
The crowd rang out with shouts of joy, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest!"
Thank you.
reverberating hosannas decayed following his triumphal entry, Jesus spent hours in the days to follow teaching in the temple area, imparting lessons of faith and life to all who gathered. Though many listened and embraced his words, there were others who questioned his authority and his teachings.
It was now the day of unleavened bread, the day when it was customary to observe the Passover feast. Jesus sent Peter and John to a home to make a preparation where he and his disciples would gather for this most cherished tradition.
When the hour came, they gathered in an upper room and shared the sacred feast. Following the meal, Jesus said to his disciples,
"With desire, I have desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer, for I say unto you, I will not any more eat thereof until it be fulfilled in the kingdom of God."
Jesus continued by taking bread, breaking it, and giving it to his disciples.
"Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me."
Then he took a cup, gave thanks, and offered it to them, saying,
"This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye, as oft as ye drink it, in remembrance of me."
For the bread which you have broken, for the wine which you have poured,
for the words which you have spoken, now we give you thanks, O Lord.
By this pledge that you do love us, by your gift of peace restored, by your call to heaven above us, consecrate our lives, O Lord.
In your service, Lord, defend.
Following the Passover meal, Jesus shared with his disciples about the days to come and the challenges they would face. He foretold how they, in fulfillment of the prophecies, would fall away, even in spite of their declarations of steadfast faithfulness.
He offered assurances.
"Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also."
He promised them that God would give them a comforter in his physical absence, the Holy Spirit.
"Peace I leave with you. Peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid." Following these intimate moments, they went to a place of solitude and prayer, Gethsemane. On this day, when many were recalling the Passover experience which had been at the heart of Israel's exodus from Egypt, Jesus fully remembered God's plan for his life. a plan that would result in him becoming the sacrificial lamb for the redemption of the world.
Of this remote garden of prayer was shattered by the din of a loud and angry crowd. Led by Judas, one of the 12, this mob, comprised of chief priests, officers of the temple guard, elders and others, seized Jesus, taking him to Caiaphas, the high priest.
There, Jesus was subjected to a trial filled with lies and mockery. Standing before the religious teachers and chief priests, false accusations abounded as they sought ways to put an end to his influence.
The misguided motives of these religious leaders ultimately resulted in the sentence that they had sought, the crucifixion of this so-called Messiah, Jesus the Christ. This one who had come serving others in love had now been sentenced to death by a crowd filled with hate.
The fulfillment of Isaiah's prophecy had become a reality on this day. He said, "He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief, and we hid as it were our faces from him. He was despised and we esteemed him not. Surely he had borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed." To a place called Calvary, which means the place of his skull, Jesus was nailed to a cross and then placed between two criminals to bear the shame and agony of a public death.
His accusers hurled insults at him even in this, his final hours.
He saved others. Himself he cannot save. If he be the King of Israel, let him now come down from the cross, and we will believe him. He trusted in God. Let him deliver him now, if he will have him. For he said, "I am the Son of God."
Even in these final moments, Jesus reflected the prevailing characteristics of his life. love for others as he prayed for his accusers.
Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do.
He even offered forgiveness to one of the criminals who died alongside of him.
Verily I say unto thee, today thou shalt be with me in paradise.
Finally, Jesus called out,
It is finished!
And then he died.
Just like the people who walk with across the hill that was pierced by the cross. It caught the blood that fell. It bore the weight of the sins of the world and the Son of God as well. It heard the voice of the without blemish, and it shook as he cried, "It is finished." Calvary's cry is come to this place. Calvary's cry is still love and grace. 2,000 years can never erase the sacrifice.
Outside Jerusalem. Great and glorious.
Only days earlier, Jesus had said these words,
"And I, if I be lifted up from earth, I will draw all men unto me."
His words were a foretelling of this moment when he would be raised up on a cross to die for the sins of the world.
As Jesus died, darkness came over the whole land. The curtain of the temple was torn into two from top to bottom. The earth shook and the rocks split open.
But the miracles of miracle was that skeptics in that moment became believers. Now, when the centurion and they that were with him, watching Jesus, saw the earthquake and those things that were done, they feared greatly, saying, "Truly, this was the Son of God."
Joseph of Arimathea, a prominent member of the council, asked for permission to remove Jesus' body from the cross. Joseph bought some linen cloth, took down the body, wrapped and placed it in a tomb cut out of the rock. Then he rolled a stone against the entrance of the tomb.
"Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends."
Jesus,
to all I hear.
end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the sepulchre.
And behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it. His countenance was like lightning, and his raiment white as snow.
And the angel answered and said unto the women,
Fear not, for I know that ye seek Jesus, which was crucified. He is not here, for he is risen. And he said, Come, see the place where the Lord lay, and go quickly, and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead. Jesus is risen.
Jesus Christ is risen today. His triumph and glory is dead. He who suffered and bled has been raised from the dead. Oh, praise his holy name. Jesus Christ is risen today.
Jesus Christ is risen today.
Of Calvary shows just how far God was willing to go to reach the world with his love. And it shows how far Jesus was willing to go for the redemption of all.
But made himself of no reputation and took upon him the form of a servant and was made in the likeness of man. And being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto the death, even the death of the cross.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
Looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God.
This is the living God, the great I am.
This is Jesus, the Holy Lamb of God.
This is Calvary's love.